Yes, yes, y'all. CFRU 93.3 FM. We've got Kelly of Moksha Yoga Studios in Guelph here on the phone with us. Hello, Kelly.
Hi, Rob.
How are you?
I'm doing great tonight. I had a yoga class and a float today, so my hump Wednesday is flowing
nice.
Really nice.
Nice. That's a good way to spend the day, doing some yoga and having a float.
Definitely.
That's nice. So first I want to talk a little bit just about yoga and, you know, kind of your practice and your experience with it. How long have you been practicing yoga?
Yeah, I've been practicing yoga for about 15 years. And I took our Moksha Yoga teacher training when it was founded by Jess and Ted, Ted Grand, Jess Robertson, about 10 years ago. And I opened Moksha Yoga Guelph about 5 years ago now, or just over 5 years. And my practice kind of began just actually wanting to rent, because I was a massage therapist before a yoga teacher. And I heard about this teacher, Jess, and they just talked really great reviews about her. So I took her class to, they're opening up a yoga studio. And that just sold me. I took one class and I just fell in love with how it made me feel. I felt mentally well, energized. I didn't look back from there. It was just a done deal for me.
Nice, nice. Yeah, no, I felt like that the first time I went in. I was just like, this is, I could deal with this. This is nice. I enjoy it. It's like, it's a kind of workout for your body that's not super, super strenuous, but still at the end you feel like, wow, I just got an incredible workout. Plus the whole, having the hot yoga, I think is really key for me, and being able to just like sweat it out and have like, you feel like renewed.
Mm-hmm.
Drink some fresh water and you're just like, this is.
Yeah, because you reset your body.
Yeah. Because, like, yeah. Our body is, it's like 80% or 85% water or something like that. So,
and a lot of times we store toxins in our outer layer, like our adipose tissue or fat, so whatever our organs can't filter out, that's where it gets stored. And when you do hot yoga, the heat actually sweats it out from those fatty areas out the skin, our largest organ. So it's a great way to kind of reduce environmental toxins, stretch the body out, strengthen. And people come for different reasons at the studio. Some it's spiritual, some it's physical, some it's stress management. So there's really no specific, like, you can just come to a class and see how you feel. Everyone comes for their own reasons.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I just had my buddy in there, I think it was a week or so ago, and he was in for the spine strengthening class.
Oh, yeah, that was killer.
And that was intense. And like the instructor, it was crazy. I was like, this is, I've never experienced it like this. Cause before it's all like really chill. And he's like drill instructor style, just like moving around, like straight this. He had like everybody going 110%.
Yeah. That class is very specific osteopathic exercises. So it's not necessarily a yoga class. It is quite different, but the awareness, kinesthetic awareness you get in that class, for reposture, if you have herniated discs or scoliosis, just that awareness you get of the muscles in the spine, when you bring that into your yoga class, is just such a great place to have that. Yeah, it's a good class. People often do that class and then they stay for the restore and massage because they work so hard. So they do. That's been a theming double that's been happening lately.
That's nice. Yeah, no, I definitely feel like having that course gave me a new sense and a new awareness of just like my posture. And even now when I'm sitting in the station or I'm at the studio and stuff, I spend a lot of my time in the day sitting in a chair, looking at a computer or on a microphone or something. And it's just, my posture's horrible.
Yeah, you don't get away with it in that class.
No.
Yeah, we
so
keep that class small too, because everyone gets adjusted in that class.
Yeah.
No hiding in that class.
No, you can't be in the corner.
Yeah.
That's nice. That's nice. Yeah, no, I enjoy it. I've only been doing it for a couple of years now, but ever since I started, I've been really enjoying it. And then also, obviously as well, you've got the tank there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we just opened up first in Canada, the Ocean Float Room. And it's kind of different from other flotation tank places that are in Toronto and anywhere that I've been in Montreal, just because we have the flotation tank and then we have a color therapy steam shower. So after you have that experience in the float room with all the Epsom salts. You get this really nice sense. It's a nice bench. There's a handheld wand, so you can do cold contrast therapy and add your own essential oils and choose your color. So it really kind of completes the experience of like a hydrotherapy and water therapy care.
Cold contrast therapy.
Oh, yeah, so hot and cold.
Yes, let me know.
The steam shower gets on, and then I'll do, like, either on my knees or my lower shins. I do a lot of, I've done a lot of the construction work here, so depending on what I've done or massaging, just if my elbows or wrists or hands, anywhere I kind of want to flesh out the joints a little bit more, I just let the steam heat it up, and then I do a little bit of cold, 10 seconds of cold.
And that really helps with, like, the muscles, like, getting, I guess, healed faster, right?
Yeah, the recovery.
The recovery of them. I've heard a lot about, I don't know if you've heard about it or gone into one or anything, these, like, cryo chambers.
Yes, and we were in Crystal Springs Resort. They had, like, a hydrotherapy circuit, but they had, like, 40,000 square feet, and they had a cryo where you do that two-minute walk, and it's, like, minus 130 or something crazy.
It's insanity. That's insane. It's minus 20 out right now, and I can't walk anywhere. I have to run.
Yeah, you go in your underwear, basically, and you walk around. They put earmuffs on you, and you can have gloves on and your shoes, and that's it.
What?
And they put some music on. Everyone's huddling around in a circle, like, walking around, because you have to keep walking, but your skin starts to feel like it's going to freeze off. It's pretty intense. But then afterwards, I was really surprised, like, what a great pain management. Like, I felt incredible, and it was just 2 minutes walking around in this freezing room. I would put one of those in if I had more room.
Yeah. Like, throw on a little extension there on the back there,
yeah.
Cryo chamber.
Yeah, if you have rheumatoid arthritis or some of those other, like, inflammation that is a key component of the pain, it really is a great therapy. I mean, you can always do a mini version of that at home with hot and cold in your shower to, like, make it accessible. But that was definitely... that for pain management, if for people with rheumatoid arthritis especially, it would be pretty incredible to have one of those around here.
Definitely. And what's the science behind it? Like, from what you've heard, what I've heard is basically that, like, having the cold exposed to the body basically freaks out all your internal organs and everything, and puts everything inside you in, like, this mode of, like, oh, we need to act fast and save the body. So it does all its work and sends out whatever little healing things that go throughout your body, and it does it really, really quick, as opposed to just, daily maintenance of your body's internal organs as they go about their business.
Well, it's the circulatory system, which is always paired with your venous return, so the blood going out and the blood coming back in, as well as your lymphatic system, which is in charge of those special things that, like, your white blood cells and all the other fluids that heal tissue.
Mm-hmm.
So in the inflammation process, you need both those systems to kind of repair and flush out the tissue, and so that's where it's really gold. The outer edge of the skin that starts to get really cold, the body starts to tune into homeostasis, so it wants to maintain your internal organs and your body temperature, and those fluid systems just kind of kick in, and just through them working to maintain your internal, you get this flushing of the outer edges of the skin and the joints and everything, and it just kind of balances. It feels really good.
Cool. I have to try it. Where's the closest one around here? Do you know?
I don't know, because that one, my sister was moving from Vancouver to Toronto.
Salt Springs, you said, right?
Yeah, she drove us. We drove on our way, and it was just a pit stop, and it's like by the Okanagan Valley.
I go over there all the time to see my buddy in Kelowna, so that's...
Oh,
yes.
It's like a half hour from Kelowna.
Oh, my goodness. I'm going there this year.
The hotel rooms there are incredible, full glass walls, and then at the hotel, you get to use it's included in your stay, the water therapy spa, and then the cryo chamber is extra. Yeah, it's a good pit stop for sure.
Yes, yes, I'm going. My buddy works at hotels in Kelowna, so he's got all the deals around for the hotels in that area. So
nice. He probably knows about Crystal Spring Resort. It's more like a golf resort.
He's talked about it. Yes, it's the one, and it's got like insane amounts of crystals in it. Like it's got like he's taking pictures there and everything. I know exactly what you're talking about now.
Yeah, that's exactly the place, and they have they're just their regular pool for the hotel is this, they colored it like this deep blue, but there's music that goes on underneath the water. So if it's quiet and there's not a lot of people, they have crystals on the ceiling and it's dark outside. So you're kind of just floating on your back, listening to this music and looking at these crystals. And they kind of, it's like the starlit ceiling in the ocean float room. They kind of just twinkle. Well, it's crystal, so it's a little more spectacular. But same twinkling idea.
Gives you that feel. That's amazing. I need to go. It is on my list of places to go. So yeah, the float tank, so it's got the crystal, like the starry lights on the roof, and then also the light in the bottom. When you float, do you go with the light on or light off?
So sometimes at different times I'll do different things. Like the sensory is really the goal. Removing all the sensory to the nervous system is really the goal of the flotation room that we have. So you turn off all the lights. But depending where you're at, like I have a lot of people who are either claustrophobic and they just leave the door open and one light on, or people who have a busy mind, that's where the starlit ceiling kind of comes into play. If your mind's really busy because the lights move around, you can it's almost like you can lull yourself into a little distraction. You know, in babies, they put those things over top of their cribs to kind of entertain them, but it's also to distract their brain so they can start to relax. They don't think about things so much. So it people go in there with different, sometimes you float and you come and you're in just a different mind state than the last time you float, so you can kind of adapt to what you need. Other people, they turn off all the lights in the room, in the shower. They don't even want to see the little thread of light around the door, and they really go for, I mean, that is a unique experience. And the way stress builds in the body, if anyone's ever felt stress creep up on them, they may, like, their back might get sore, or they might get painful in the neck, or they get headaches. However your stress builds up, that's where decompressing and removing the stress on the body in the float room, whatever your pathway is, that's where it begins. So it really is unique. Some people just have increased digestion. If you're one that loses your appetite when you get stressed, like, it really is an individual experience how it kind of lands in the body. And then again, the more frequently you do it, the more resilience you build up in the nervous system. So when you decompress the nervous system and you get stressed, how quickly you rebound back to your ground zero is really kind of gold. That's how we want to live. So we do yoga, we do massages, we do floating, just to get our ground zero to recover quickly so we can adapt better.
You really know like the science behind it all. I like that. Like, you've done your research with this stuff, you can tell.
Yeah, I have a long, well, it's been 15 years that I've been a massage therapist, and I've studied one osteopathic program for 4 years, but I'm definitely into neuroscience and science and, you know, just how to create better living for myself, share it with people, and, you know, keep that. I mean, that 10,000 hours, like, I feel like you can just continue to learn. There's just no stopping.
No, you can never be a full master. You can always learn new things, for sure. Even the master can learn some new stuff.
Yeah, definitely. I love learning from students. That's probably my biggest. I constantly learn from students. It's great.
Big time, big time. I wanted to ask you just a little bit, if we can, talking about the whole spiritual aspect of it, especially in context of the float tanks, because I feel like when I've been in there, sometimes like some really crazy stuff has happened, and it's definitely had some out of body experiences there, and went to some crazy other worlds.
Yeah, I am.
Can you speak a little bit on your experience?
Well, because you're Well, I feel like I want to call you a musician. Do DJs call themselves musicians? I don't know.
Yeah. Well, like I'm a musician, so I'm a rapper. I call myself a musician.
Yeah. So that works certain the creative areas of the brain, which is a great starting point when you go into the float room and you renew. You when you de-stress, you open yourself up to free thinking. And that free thinking can, depending on what your starting point is, because sometimes, you know, if you're an accountant and that's what you're doing every day, you know, having a numbers dream, you know, maybe they do, I don't know. But it's not that side of the brain that allows for that kind of free outer body experience. So you might have to practice a little bit more to get to that place where you go in and you let go enough, the analytical part of the brain, to let that free thinking part of the brain come out. And so with just seeing different people go in there, it really is dependent on how they're feeling, but also whether they have that, they're kind of open to that creative part of the brain.
Mm-hmm. Or even just the idea of like having an outer body experience. I'm sure some people are just like, what are you talking about? I can leave my body and go somewhere else. Like,
yeah. You're like, no, I just had a nap. Like, and that's good too. A woman just had an extra long nap today. Like, that's, you know, you kind of take away, it's just like a yoga class. You come in and you just take from it what you need. You just start from where you're at, and that's exactly where you need to be. And it's always different for me every time I float. I mean, sometimes there's a little bit of a theme coming up in life. If some things are a little challenging or overwhelming, then I know, even if your brain doesn't go to that place, like, sometimes people are like, oh, you're so lucky, you just kind of zen out. And it's just working a different area of the brain, but your nervous system is getting 100% the benefits, whether you're having an outer body experience or, you know, you're just trying to focus on one point, you're breathing and just kind of soothe yourself. So it's not that one has a more impact on the nervous system. It's just one's a different color than the other.
Definitely, yeah. It is pretty cool to have those experiences, though, because the other times I go into the tank and it doesn't happen, I'm just like, what happened? Did I need to get more calmer? Did I need to, like, relax a little bit more? Okay, I got to try harder at that next time. And then it's like, when you try harder, it doesn't work as good, right? The whole point of, like, tapping into that spiritual realm is, like, not trying at all and just being you, right? Being whatever it is inside of us.
Stop being the doer and just be in the moment.
That's
true. More challenging at some time, and expectation, like, it's really hard not to compare. And that's sometimes why I don't like when people come in and they ask, what's it like? I don't like to give them an idea. It's like, just go in carte blanche with a blank mind with no expectations and just be with wherever you're at, one breath at a time, and just try not to think about it.
Yeah, sometimes I oversell it a little bit. They're like, what's it like? I'm like, oh, you don't even know, man. It's so amazing. Like, I lie down.
Totally. And I did that to my partner, Nick. He, to Crystal Springs Resort, I was like, I went out and I did the Moksha Flow training in Kelowna. And so he came and met me at the end of the trip, and we booked a hotel room. But there was like nobody there when my sister and I were there, so it was so quiet. We had the whole place to ourselves. It was incredible.
That's nice.
And then when he came, they must have had a special on or something, and there were so many people that, like, you couldn't hear the underwater music, and it wasn't as magic as it was the first time for me.
Yeah.
So it's like, I think you might have oversold this place a little bit, but the hotel room makes up for it, because it really is, your whole one wall in your hotel room is all windows.
Yeah.
So it's that part he liked, but I think I, the enthusiasm got a hold of me. <He's> like, I don't know, but I love it there. I'd always go back there. It's great.
Awesome. Well, I need to book that in this year. It's happening.
Mm-hmm.
I'll check that out. I like the recommendation, definitely.
Yeah, it's a good one. I'm a bit of I try to go to every relaxation center I can wherever I am, whether it's like hydrotherapy or spa or just something someone yelped about, like a local massage therapist just to kind of see how people do things and smaller touches.
Do you know any places locally here, some of the listeners that are tuning in from like Toronto area, Brampton, yeah, that kind of stuff? Is there any float tanks available in that area or anywhere around here that you know
Toronto?
About?
Yeah, there's a great place that just opened up, H2O Spa in the Danforth. And they have, if you are claustrophobic, they actually have an open concept tiled area where they have some infrared heating panels that we use in the studio. And so that's over so you don't get cold in the float room. And I had a lovely experience there. They were great. It was really, I didn't try the pods, but I think they have two pods and two open concept rooms and maybe one massage therapy room. But the first time I floated was like 12 or 15 years ago at the Toronto Healing Arts Center, and they have one tank available at their place. And they have tanking for two. You could buy a package and sometimes share. And I just wouldn't recommend tanking with someone. I tried to tank with my partner, and we just accidentally bumped into each other. And, you know, it just kind of wrecks your meditation flow. Like, this is a solo journey. There's no two people in a pod. Nope.
Yeah, doesn't work.
No.
I'd be interested.
Night, it is nice to have two tanks so you can float at the same time, but not in the same one.
Yes, that would be cool. And try, like, I don't know, I've just recently been researching a little bit about astral projection during dreams and lucid dreaming, and then meeting up with different people in the dream world, you know what I mean? And like planning it out with whoever, whether it be your partner or somebody that you're friends with or close with or something, and then like planning it out. That would be amazing to try and practice that with two float tanks.
Man, our next renovation, I'm kind of cut off from renovations because I did a little too much.
But it looks
one
nice.
One day, more than one float tank would be very ideal.
Definitely. Yeah, no, it looks nice in there. And the new massage room, like with the starry sky thing going on too. I like
it. Yeah, I was a little jealous of the float room with the starlit ceiling. So we put them in both the massage rooms too, which was a task in itself because my electrician was like, you're going to put LED starlit ceilings in the massage rooms. Do you know how much time that takes? You're just drilling a little hole and gluing a little fiber in. How long can that take? I'm like, well, it did take quite a bit of time, but it was well worth it.
Yeah, definitely. And then as far as maintaining the float tank for, you know, keeping it going and stuff like that, like how often do you have like problems with it, repairs and stuff like that, or is it fairly you know, like, I don't know. I'm just interested about it because I eventually definitely want to make a purchase in my life. Like, I love coming there. I want to have my own eventually, get one in my home.
One in your own house is the goal, really.
Yeah.
Like, discover it here. And then, I mean, there's lots of options. There's lots of, like, home kits that, you know, do-it-yourself kind of float room. And I think soundproofing is probably the biggest thing with float tanks. But the maintenance of it's pretty general. Like, you change the filter. The cleaning system is great. It gets cleaned twice in between, like, every cubic inch of water. It gets filtered twice in between each person. And just adding the salt and balancing out the, like, they have this special formula for, like, ocean clear so the water stays clear and stuff. But it's pretty simple to run. And, I mean, there's not a lot. Nothing's broken or anything, so it's pretty easy going.
Awesome. Yeah. Awesome. Well, it's going to happen in my life. It's a goal. It's on there. It's going to happen. I will get myself a float tank, and it will have to have a steam shower as well.
Right?
With the funky lights.
I know my son, he comes and he floats. He just loves it. And when he leaves, he's like, can you make our house like the yoga studio, please? Like, one day, yes. Yeah.
That's nice. Awesome. Well, it was great talking with you, Kelly. I'm sure we could go on for hours and talk about crazy astral stuff, and hopefully we'll get a chance to connect again and maybe have you come into the studio as well sometime.
Yeah, that sounds great. Thanks for so much giving me the opportunity to share a little bit of information about our new service. Yeah, and the health benefits.
Of course, anytime.
Awesome. Thanks, Rob.
All right, take care. Have a good night.
Okay, you too.
Bye.
Bye.